kitchen. So I am super excited today because first off, I just called this my kitchen.
What?
This is my kitchen. So obviously nothing is done. If you haven't seen it yet, if I've uploaded it, I did film an empty house tour. So if you're curious and you're like, what's going on? What's in the house? You want to know the stuff we're going to be doing in the kitchen because we are going to be doing some construction in this kitchen, then go watch that video. I will have that link down below. But today I am super excited because Dan and I have been married for almost 10 years now. And in the entire 10 years, we've not really ever bought much new kitchen stuff. Like, we've had the same cookware since the beginning, which I know is super common, but I use and abuse my stuff pretty badly. And we bought our first new set of knives, so that's actually not in here. But point being, when we moved to Nashville, we decided to not bring with us a lot of stuff, and we decided to start fresh with a bunch of new things for so many reasons. A, like I said, we've had so much over 10 years, and B, if any of you are interested in stuff that I'm ever using in cooking videos from now on, and you want like that exact piece, you'll be able to buy it. So, hi! So today I'm gonna show you what I got, so I'll just jump right in, and just like I said 2 seconds ago, I'm actually gonna link all of this down below too. I don't know if anyone's gonna wanna check it out after me just like showing it to you and hauling it. All right, here we go. So, first item, I have wanted this for so long, but I never did it because Dan, who is filming this video, is kind of a stickler for quality, and he wasn't quite sure that these were airtight, and we just went back and forth on it a lot, and I convinced him when we were shopping. I was like, Dan, these are like Pinterest organizational goals. I need these, and if they're a mistake, then oh well, I made a mistake, but I don't think it's gonna be a mistake. So these are from OXO or OXO, I don't know. They're like, I think the brand's called like NivSoft or NivLife or I don't know, it says Good Grips. And just like you can see, it's a 10-piece pop container set. These are airtight, according to the woman at Williams-Sonoma, which, by the way, this whole haul is half Williams-Sonoma and some of it's Target, but this was Williams-Sonoma. Although I do think they sell these at Target too. And yeah, it's pretty self-explanatory. You can see all the different things you can store in here. I will not be surprised if I end up wanting to go back and buy another set. Like, I totally foresee myself going crazy with these in our cupboards because I just think it's so easy and cool. So that's the first thing I got. Next thing, Dan and I have been using the same janky pot and pan holders for years. Dan's eyebrows just raised high. So I decided to get some not only really cute ones, look at how cute this is, totally matches our vibe. And they're matching, but on top of that, I kind of, whether this is true or not, I just assumed because it was Williams-Sonoma, I'm like, these are probably good quality ones. A couple of my pan holders, actually, if you hold the pan for more than a couple seconds, you're like, I think this is burning through and it's going to burn my hand. So, very, very exciting. So cute, I love the pattern. Next up, we got some measuring cups. Now, these measuring cups, this is the Williams-Sonoma brand. They're stainless steel, and they go all the way down to a fourth of a teaspoon, and then they go all the way up, I think, to 2 cups? I actually don't know, but you've got all of the cups. Oh, no, no, it goes all the way up to 1.5 cups, so not 2 cups. So yeah, I just needed some new measuring cups, and it had the little holes at the end, so you can link together all of your sizes. So we'll probably link these in 2 batches, like the teaspoon, tablespoon, spoon measurements, and then the cup measurements. So, pretty excited about that. Usually I just wing it, but now that I'm gonna be baking, when it gets colder here, you can't really wing it with baking, because baking is more of a science. So, then we did bring a lot of our ramekins with us. They're going to get here tomorrow. This is kind of a store flip. But I knew we wanted a couple more ramekins because we also got rid of a couple when we left that weren't doing so hot. So I bought 4 ramekins that are these from Target. I use ramekins like crazy. If you want to do taco bars, pasta bars, avocado toast bars, any kind of bar and you want to lay out your toppings, ramekins are amazing. Also, if you're cooking anything, whether it's baking or just cooking, you can always pre-do your ingredients, cut them up, stick them in little bowls, and lay out the bowls. And when you're cooking, you can just dump everything in the right order. Also, if you like treats, but you don't want to go overboard, I'll sometimes use these as like little ice cream bowls or really whatever. It's just like the perfect tiny little bowl. So, all right, so speaking of bowls, I did get some more bowls from Target. We never seem to have enough bowls, which is really weird. But all of these bowls, I believe, are all the same ones. And this is from their Threshold line. I think that all of the ramekins are from their Threshold line too. Maybe it's called 3-Bowl. I actually don't know. There's a sticker on remember it. But I love Target Place because they have a whole wall in Target where it's all white stuff. So if you're like us and you really like to display your food and eat your food on white, they have all kinds of pieces. So we just got four bowls to start off with. Everything we got, this sounds kind of sad because we got a lot of stuff, but it's all kind of like, oh, let's just use it and then see what it's like when everything else gets here. So we may end up having to go do a little more shopping because I don't really remember everything we brought. So Dan is lifting his eyebrows and pointing at my giant stack of ramekins. It looks like it's about to fall over. There we go. So next up, we got some plates from Target. I think also in the same line, yes, it is Threshold. So these are all just basic white plates. I don't know what they call these little dinner plates. I like to eat on plates like this sometimes, like if I'm having pasta. Really like, I hate to use the word portion control, but it's the same thing with the ramekins. It's nice to eat off of smaller dishes, depending on the food that you're eating sometimes. But the Room Essentials brand is actually like the Target brand. Threshold might be theirs too, I'm not sure. But like you just said, they're half the cost of the other plates. So yeah, they're stoneware, dishware, microwave safe, and we got a bunch.
I think it's like $2.50 opposed to $5 a plate.
Yeah, deals on deals. So yeah, then behind me, back to William Sonoma, we can always use a wood spoon. So we got a really cute wood spoon, but it has a P. Oh, we should have gotten an N and a D too. That's so cute. So wood spoon, and another thing we got at William Sonoma is another lemon press. Dan was a huge fan of this lemon press. I'm not gonna lie, I kinda get it. I mean, you can feel that it's made really well. Actually, you really can feel it's made really well. Well, this is a $25 lemon press, so that makes sense. But we've broken.
It's not that it's made well, it's that just the functionality, it'll actually work opposed to the other one we had.
Gotcha. See, this is what I mean. Dan is very specific about these things. And we have ruined a few lemon presses, or like they chip. This also doesn't seem like the paint is gonna chip. Like, have you guys seen those cheap, like $5 lemon presses? They'll do the job, but eventually the paint starts to chip off and maybe like it becomes uneven. I don't know. I'm excited to have a quality lemon press. I juice a lemon every single day of my life for something. So then I bought something that I haven't had since Dan and I first got married. And the one that we had when we first got married wasn't very good quality, but this is a stainless steel, once again, OXO salad spinner. Yes, guys, you're gonna be so grossed out by me, but some of you guys are gonna be like, eye roll, typical Nikki. I haven't washed any salads that I buy in like 9 years. I don't even know, since very early in our marriage. I stopped because A, I got lazy. B, our salad spinner wasn't that great, so it left the salad still a little wet. And C, I read The Kind Diet by Alicia Silverstone, and she was saying she never washes her produce because even if there's a little bit of dirt on it, dirt has vitamin B12 in it, so she just eats it up. So I used all of those things as my excuse. But now I have a salad spinner. Yay! For videos, for serving things. This is technically like a cheese plate, if you want to call it that. I mean, that's what they call it. But I'll probably use this, like I said, just to display things in videos or make little snacks. I love like making, yeah, little snacks. I'm about to repeat myself and setting them out. So I thought this was really pretty. So I'm excited about that. All right, so the next thing that we got for two reasons. It's this baking little sheet. It's this marble sheet. Now, two reasons we got it are, one, because I am going to start baking more, and I have heard from many people that this is specifically for baking for some reason, the way that the dough rolls and all of that. So I'll be using it for that, but also, like I said, I'm going to be changing out the countertops to white, but I don't know how long that's going to take, and I am very weirdly like specific about when we film my food. I like it to be filmed on white. I think that the coloring looks better. So we got it for both purposes because it might be a little while till we get our counters. Although hopefully not. I would really like them soon and less, so we'll see. So next thing, Dan and I are really excited about this. We got this Softworks, once again, OXO spiralizer. I just like it sounds, it spiralizes veggies. So you can take your food and you can do ribbon cuts, fettuccine cuts, spaghetti cuts. And I'm so excited because I totally want to make pasta out of like butternut squash and zucchini and, oh my gosh, potato. Like this is gonna be cool because I've tried some noodles recently made out of veggies and, well, many times over the years, and I love them. So that is extremely exciting. Then, okay, next. We got a new pan. Nothing too exciting here, although I think this is the heaviest cookie sheet I've ever held in my life. It's the Williams-Sonoma Traditional Tough brand. Heavy gauge aluminized steel bakeware. It's definitely heavy gauge. This is a half sheet pan. Looks like a regular pan to me, Williams-Sonoma. It's heavy though. It's definitely heavy duty. So, next up, we got two new cutting boards. We got a small one, once again, from the Williams-Sonoma brand. And then, as well as the small one, we got a really large one right over here. So, just like this, we got light wood for both of them. This wood is so heavy. Also, I keep getting distracted because fall is definitely almost here, and I've been watching so many leaves fall from the tree lately. It's really pretty. So, and then for those wood cutting boards, because apparently there is a way you have to like take care of the wood cutting board or it starts to peel apart and just doesn't last as long.
We know that, we've never done it.
Well, I didn't really register that, and you know that I'd never do it, but guess who will do it? Details Dan!
I never wanted to do it because we never bought a nice cutting board, but.
You love when we buy nice things and then we have like the stuff to take care of it. So you know he bought this. It's the Booze Block Board Cream. Natural moisturizer for all types of wood surfaces. Don't really ask me how you do it. I think like once a month you wipe it down in this. Something like that. So we got that. So on to our last two things. I think these are the most exciting of the whole shopping batch. So first thing is we got this pasta pot. You see this? Now, when I was in the store, I asked the woman, I was like, okay, expert cooking lady, because the woman at Williams-Sonoma was literally, she couldn't have been more helpful. Even though you're probably not watching this video, shout out to you if you are, because you were awesome. And I said to her, I was like, on the Pioneer woman, she's always cooking with this really fancy insert, like into her pot when she cooks pasta. So she'll pull the insert out and just drains all the pasta water. Do you sell that insert? And she was like, actually, it's not an insert, it's a whole separate pot that you have to buy. But she said that it's not only easier, but she said there's also a real reason. And apparently when you have that little net insert that goes in the pot, you don't have to stir the pasta, which does not like chemically disrupt the makeup of the actual pasta. But do you remember the other reason? There's another reason too.
If you don't have that, the pasta sticks to the bottom of the pan.
That too.
So you have to constantly stir the pasta, and like you said, it does something with the starch.
Yeah, which I would imagine changes the taste.
I guess it changes the taste and it's the way the pasta sauce adheres to the noodle.
Gotcha. Now you know. Ooh. So we got one of those. So
your pasta will taste better.
Ooh. Yeah, if it's cooked in here. So I couldn't be more excited because I love the Pioneer Woman, and now I'm gonna have what the Pioneer Woman has. So that's exciting. Now the last thing we got, which is the most exciting, brand new 10-piece cookware set. Guys.
Which really it's lying, it's 5 pieces.
Yeah, because they count every piece as like, you get a lid, it's a piece. So I'm a little bit like, okay, Williams-Sonoma. But it is a stainless steel thermoclad cookware set. And apparently, so it's not non-stick, so you have to cook with like a little bit of oil or something in there. But apparently with the thermal clad and it being stainless steel, it helps to really conduct the heat better from our gas stove. Because we do have a gas stove and now a gas oven. And so it's gonna help to evenly distribute the heat so our food cooks better, and which is great because that's actually a problem we've actively had on previous cookware. And we just got used to it because it's a super first world problem, like not that big of a deal. But as someone who loves food and really loves cooking, I'm so, so excited for this cookware set. So yeah, guys, when I make all my cooking videos, you are gonna see me now cooking in here, cooking on this cookware set. I can't wait. I feel like my food tastes are going to be even more expanded by living here in Nashville. I'm just excited to share. So that is it, guys. I'll see you all back here soon with another new video. Hope you're having a fabulous day. We have so many flipping videos come up. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel if you haven't subscribed already. That's the best way to get alerted, to show support. Actually, you could totally share my videos on social media if you want. That's probably the best way to show support. No, there's so many ways to support. Thank you so much for everything, guys. I said that in my house video. You are the reason we get to do all of this. Your support means more to me and Dan than we can ever explain. So I love you guys. Mwah, and I'll see you soon. Bye.